Wellness and AI, and a giant buffet of recipes. Get ready for Chef Govind at the Cozy AI Kitchen. So if you've ever been to a banquet and you see all these amazing dishes and you can't wait to eat them, that's how you're gonna feel the way I felt when I saw the banquet prepared by Chef Govind. Chef Govind, welcome to Cozy AI Kitchen.
Hi, John, how are you?
I've heard of the Sip and Sync show. It's a wonderful show. You're the co-host of that.
That's right, and inspired by what you've been doing here. So thank you.
My God, he's such a nice guy. All right, so Chef Govind, I understand that you've been challenged by different industries out there to cook different meals, and you have something new today to share.
That's right. You know, it's been a while since we launched this AI Foundry, and there's been a lot of confusion and lack of clarity because we've been, you know, rebranding, and partially it's on us. But I do think that we can kind of make this really fun and engaging to introduce you to the new AI Foundry, you know, concepts. There's a lot of SDKs. There's a lot of capabilities hidden behind, and you know, nobody is finding a integrated repo or notebooks that they can cook with. So.
And how do we share that energy? By making, right?
Yes, exactly.
So please share that making, Chef Govind.
Perfect. So this is also partially inspired by what John did a while ago with Semantic Kernel. So what I have here are a bunch of notebooks. And the cool thing is everyone who's watching this can go ahead and quickly get started. And as you go through these notebooks, you'll actually, it's very fun and engaging. So, you know, hopefully you'll learn some health tips and wellness tips as you run through these notebooks.
It's pretty tiring, this AI, so you gotta be healthy, right?
Exactly, that's the point of life, is to have, you know, a calm mind and a fit body.
Okay, let's go.
All right, let's go. So, so if you go to aka.ms/WKSP, and the link will be below, you know, you can follow along as we do this. So I organized these notebooks with introduction, where, you know, it just shows how you can just authenticate, just do some basic sanity checks that you have, you know, that you went to ai.azure.com, set up some basic models and things like that. And we have an episode in Sip and Sync that we'll also link right here that you can kind of follow along to get that setup started. And then after that, the fun begins. So I kind of organize again in three sub notebooks. The first one is just basic chat completion. So here.
And chat completion being?
Good point. So when ChatGPT kind of came out, or Copilot, the way we, that's right.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah. The model.
The model, exactly. The way we interact with the model is by asking it questions. And it's actually a huge database. So it has a lot of pre-trained knowledge. And it answers from its pre-trained knowledge. So chat completion is just the API version of ChatGPT or Copilot.
It completes the sentence.
It completes the sentence, yes, the next word.
Go ahead.
So first, you know, we do basic stuff. And if you notice, one thing about these notebooks is there's no usage of passwords. We want to do this as securely as possible and follow the best security principles. And then the second sort of cell, as you run through these cells, you know, it's pretty self-explanatory, and I added a lot of comments.
This is super fun. You're like fit chat GPT. This is good.
Yeah, exactly. So this is the cell that's actually talking to the model and asking the model, hey, how can I start a beginner workout routine at home? And here the model responded back. Super easy, just a couple lines of code.
That's a chat completion.
Yeah. And then the cool thing about our new Azure AI Foundry SDKs is they have all these primitives or functions that allow you to evolve your application to do complex stuff. For example, maybe you want to have some variables in your prompts. Maybe you want to ask the user for a goal and their name. Like, you might have a personal trainer. So,
and you want variables because you can use it like a function, right?
That's right. Yeah. Mm. Yeah. So here we're just saying fit chat your AI personal trainer for my name or some name. And in this case, Jordan. And then I want to increase muscle tone and endurance. And there you go. Yeah. Responded back again.
Congratulations, we did it.
Congratulations, you did it.
Okay, this is a nice, these recipes go like this. They're short bursts of code.
Exactly.
I love it. And you have so many kinds in this. You have like a whole Wikipedia of examples. What's your favorite example?
Yeah, so I do like the embeddings one because I think it introduces, I'm just going to scroll up.
We love embeddings in the Cozy AI Kitchen.
Exactly.
Thank you. Here it is. This is just like grandma used to make, vector embeddings. Very important.
There we go. So in the embeddings notebook, again, we're highlighting how you can use, of course, we use text embeddings like that, but we can also do image embeddings. So we have a image here of of a hand x-ray. Exactly.
Okay.
And you can, you know, use the embeddings notebook, and in addition to text embeddings, you can actually do image embeddings. So
you can take an image and turn it into a long vector too, just like text.
Exactly.
Yeah. Embeddings.
It's
love
just
embeddings.
High-dimensional, you know, space where concepts are mapped. And then we can search around.
How long does it take?
I'm just running the above notebooks.
Okay. No problem. That happens.
Books. Here we go.
Okay. Exciting. So it's taking an image and producing a long vector.
Yep.
Just like it would have a text.
Image.
There it is.
Now it's the image embedding. Here we go.
Okay.
There we go. Okay. So the hand x-ray is now running. I just had to run the above cells because I need the project client.
Yep. Super fast.
There we go.
Wow.
That's the image embedding.
Huh.
And then the last one is, of course, to generate images as well. We all use DALL-E 3 or Stable Diffusion, et cetera.
Text to image.
Exactly, text to image.
Mm-hmm.
For the creative minds like John.
like Chef Govind. Mm.
So here we're just, in this case, I actually just generated a watercolor painting of fresh fruits and vegetables arranged in a heart shape.
So delicious looking.
And healthy.
And I see you have agents in your recipe book.
And there's a whole subfolder of agents. Now, there's a lot of talk about agents, and it seems complex, but it really isn't.
How do I make an easier way to understand that? How do you do that?
Yeah, so I have a bunch of notebooks here that add more tools to the agent. So at the heart of it, you know, agent kind of works in an environment and, you know, reasons over the knowledge that it has, but then it can also take actions.
Yeah, well, and agents has models, prompts, knowledge, and tools.
There we go. So that's how I kind of organized it. Notebooks, I highlight different tool usage. In this case, it shows code interpreter. So let me just run
these.
Such
a beautiful recipe book. Wow.
Thank you. And inspired by what you've done with the
Kernel. You know, in life, you wait for the person, the chef that's going to come and take your lunch. And here at the moment here, Chef Govind.
So here we're basically, you know, creating a health calculator agent.
Oh, so cool.
And obviously, we all want to know our BMI and things of that nature. So we don't want the model to hallucinate and give us the wrong BMI. We want to be fit with the right and correct and mathematically accurate information.
Mm.
So we're having the model actually write code and use its code interpreter tool to actually give us a correct answer and also visualize that. So
let's pause for a second on that. So we've heard of software engineering agents, SWE agents. You're talking about code interpreter being accessible as a tool. Can you slow down a bit and explain how is that possible?
Yeah. So SWE agents are composed of tools like code interpreter and maybe a web browser, maybe a sandbox, et cetera. And code interpreter is one of the ingredients that a SWE agent will need because a SWE agent essentially is, you know, a software engineer. If you think about it, they have to write code, they have to test the code, and they have to validate that the code that they wrote meets the acceptance criteria.
So the agent has available to them a developer on demand.
Exactly. Yeah.
Pretty cool.
And here we go. So it calculated. It gave actual math that was, run on CPU.
Because it wrote code. It's working code. In numbers. It can do numbers really well.
That's right. And also, it can do charts. Right. So here's
a
nutrition trends chart that it wrote Python code and imported the packages to generate this.
You have all the file search, AI search, Bing. You've got like everything in here.
Yep. So because agents have tools. So here, if you go through these notebooks again, you all can go through this and get the feel and really, it's super easy. The point I want to drive here is that it can be fun, engaging, and easy. And you can use it for your own applications.
I'm so excited because you could be in this for like weeks here. There's like so many. You've got quality attributes. Yeah. You do evals too?
Yes, yes. So one of the biggest thing is agents have goals, but they also have guardrails. Mm-hmm. And the guardrails and evaluations are just as important, if not more important. Because we want to make sure that as you stitch these agents together to automate workflows, you don't want that error rate to compound. And more importantly, you also want to do things safely, and you want to follow the best principles of, AI sort of safety, and we have a lot of tools and capabilities and evaluations. So again, I want to make it easy, so I have a full notebook.
So you want to test them, basically.
Exactly, you want to test them, yeah. It's like we did TDD, test-driven development, last decade, and now we are doing eval-driven development.
Yeah, it's like, did it do it right or not? You want to check. It's quality control, as you said, QC.
For a stochastic system, it's a little bit different. So here, we go through, it's a large notebook, but that's on purpose, because we want to highlight everything that you can do with our Foundry SDKs and our evaluation SDKs.
This is a dream come true for so many, including myself. So this is incredible. Can you talk about frameworks? You have frameworks as
well. Sure, I have frameworks as well.
You seem like you have every framework possible there.
So I have two to get started with, and there's more to come. Mm-hmm. I have Semantic Kernel.
Semantic Kernel.
John's favorite, and my favorite too. So here's Semantic Kernel. We're highlighting how you can use Semantic Kernel with our AI agent service. And AI search. So it's a basic retrieval augmented generation notebook where you first populate AI search index. Again, keeping with the health theme here.
Nice.
One second. Wow, let me
just run. Same thing happens to me. Sometimes it wants to run forever. It's like forever
running the other notebook and this notebook. So keeping with the health fitness, I have some yoga mat and treadmill and dumbbells here that I'm adding to the search index. There we go.
Gosh.
And now I'm verifying, and then I am doing. I'm using Semantic Kernel's primitives to do a RAG over that search index.
Yeah.
And you've already explained RAG.
Mm-hmm. Yes. But I love how you press run all. I'm always conscious of that.
Me too.
You're tough.
I'm taking the risk.
Chef Govind going far on the cooking here.
The demo gods will cooperate.
Well, Chef Govind, this is a set of recipes that I think anyone could spend really literally weeks on.
Yep.
And when you think about cozy AI, this is a moment where AI is a little bit scary to people. So, there are developers out there trying to figure this out. Maybe they're too busy in their regular day job, or even students out there that maybe their school didn't teach them about this, but they heard or they saw some video or whatever. What advice do you have to give to them as someone who I think is one of the master chefs of our time in AI. So what advice do you have for them?
So I would say, get started with your own, workflow or mundane task that you have where you don't want to do it. There are things that I've done where I've automated a lot of my mundane tasks as well using AI because that made this more relevant for me. And then I could apply with tools like this. And I also have another end-to-end application that shows, AI in action. And there's many out there. And then when you apply to something that is relevant, then you'll find it's useful. And then that's the best way to learn, in my opinion. Just start applying to things that you're passionate about, things that you care about. That's the way to go.
So do you have any closing thought on that? Yeah, can you sort of because everyone's like fascinated by, you got to see the sip and sink, they see you in action. Now you're showing like this essentially a Guernica of things. how can they relate to the next phase of technology better?
Yeah, I actually have two things to show. That's okay. So one thing, in the same repo, there's actually a whole sample that showcases different intelligent workflows in action.
Wow.
You know, there's a whole topic about deep research. But you can actually, you know, do deep research on your own data. You know, that's using our AI agent service and all of the things that you, so this is just kind of packaging up everything that you've learned in the notebook into an application, you know, that you can use.
Wow, that's actually, you took the cooking and you brought it into the restaurant practice.
Exactly. And then the other thing is, you know, there's also different patterns that you can learn by going through this. And the other thing that I have is, you know, for me, the most important thing is having a calm mind. And I'm actually working on something that we'll save for later, you know, where you can hyper-personalize this AI and, you know, use a device, a brain-computer interface device to do that. So looking forward to sharing that with you and as well as on our Sip and Sync show later.
Brain computer human interface. I'm jealous. Okay. Thank you, everyone, for joining us. And stay tuned. Watch Sip and Sync and come back to the Cozy AI Kitchen. And let's try to keep you cozy. Thank you.
Thank you.